Can you stop looking at me?
You just had to tweet at producer Drew.
Let's go.
Good. We all feel good.
Stop. Never gets rusty.
What am I doing?
Get in my kitchen. Producer Drew, can you fix all this?
And when it comes to the Toronto Maple Leafs, you can crumple, crumple, yeet.
Saw that going differently.
With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
No! This is my nightmare!
Le who? The her.
Well, if you didn't know before today, I'm sure you'll know now. These videos are edited by a Colorado Avalanche fan. His name is producer Drew, and this sucks! Leafs lose 5-3 in regulation. That's the only way to lose 5-3 to the Colorado Avalanche! And if you were curious as to what kind of video you were tuning into, they are getting tuned! Proper tuned! Shawn Michaels tuning up the band! Sweet chin music, baby! HBK, the heartbreak kid! Because they did it! The Leafs did it! Drop the confetti, everybody! They did it! They found a way to take a game where they had a 3-0 lead on home ice heading into first intermission, and they turned it into a game where there were no, I repeat, no positive takeaways. You can take away nothing good about this game. Not a single thing.
Ooh, third line was pretty good.
The third line's supposed to be good. You know, on most good teams, that's not a nightly dilemma.
Oh, can we throw the bottom six on the ice? No, because we're spending all the money on four guys.
It's okay. Next year, it's going to get better. Sorry, did I say better? I mean, two of them are getting raises.
Did you see a $13.25 million effort out there?
Huh?
From anyone?
No. Did you see an $11.5 million effort out there from anyone? Bueller? Anyone? Did you see an $11 million effort out there? Definitely not in the third period, you didn't. And did you see a $10.9 million effort out there?
No!
I'm not even gonna talk about the fact that the Leafs scored. Actually, there is one little thing that, just because I'm obsessed with this stuff, I have to talk about. They had three goals in the first period to go up 3-0. Somehow, all of them unassisted. That's not noteworthy, it's just really weird.
Now listen, I am not on the Fire Sheldon Keefe bandwagon right now. Some fans have been that for a month. Some fans have been that since the beginning of the season. Some fans have been that since before they got eliminated by Florida. I will say this though, I think that was the worst coached game, at least regular season game, from Sheldon Keefe in his tenure as Leafs head coach and therefore as an NHL coach.
This is what is getting all the headlines today. The third period ice time. Marner was up there. Nylander was up there. Matthews was up there because they were all on a line together. Then it was Yarncroke, Domi, and David Kampf for some reason. Holmberg, who would have been on with Yarncroke and Domi, so that would have made a little more sense. Tavares at 318, Noah Gregor at 315, Nyes 214, Tyler Bertuzzi didn't even sniff the ice, 121.
Because I get it, listen, those guys didn't have a great night. I'm a little confused about Tyler Bertuzzi, but Tavares and Nyes had moments, teachable moments, that Sheldon Keefe was mad at, and we'll talk about those. But here's where it falls flat, ladies and gentlemen. Here's where it falls a little flat, the trying to send a message, trying to get through to my guys, because they played poorly, they did something that they shouldn't have done, so you take away their ice time, right? You take it away. You take it away from them in the third period.
Except, with less than 20 seconds to go in a one goal game! You put out a line of Tavares, Nyes, and Gregor? How do you show up to the rink tomorrow and look your team in the eye? What is this? What is this? What is this Frankenstein's monster? Tavares passing to Nyes because he's like an offensively capable player while Gregor just blows offside.
When was the last time Noah Gregor was out there on the ice with 20 seconds to go and his team down one? Has it happened in his NHL career? Has it happened as a Leaf?
The first person who needs to be held accountable for this game is me. Because producer Nick tweeted this picture at me of producer Drew being very upset because his team was losing 3-0. And I said, how are you enjoying the game?
And I don't know this, I haven't spoken to him, but I'm willing to guess
he had a great time!
Second, as long as we're talking about accountability, Mark Giordano has probably been the worst Leaf in two straight games.
He was definitely the worst Leaf against the Islanders. And Sheldon Keefe just said, like just said in the media a few days ago,
Well, the decor's been good, and I don't see a reason to make any changes. You can now. You can now. The oldest active skater in the NHL has been terrible for two straight games. That's enough. So, Leafs 3-0. Mark Giordano takes a penalty because he hasn't been playing very well. Leafs head to the penalty kill. Can I show you how little effort it took to score on the Leafs on this goal? Three members of the Colorado Avalanche are standing completely upright, and the other guy isn't even on the screen yet! If you look to the middle, you look right into the slot, that's the guy who scored! Nathan MacKinnon casually passes the puck to Ross Colton, and TJ Brody, you see him turn around in a panic like, oh no, was that my line? Jake McCabe, standing completely upright going, oh, maybe it's my line. Those two are night at the Roxbury. Me, you, me, me, you, me. Passing the slot to Jonathan Drouin, that's super easy, it's 3-1. Late in the second period, Leafs still up 3-1. Matthew Nyes loses his stick. The puck goes towards the point. Nyes' stick goes towards the Leaf net. What do you think he chooses? I'm bringing home a baby, Bumblebee! No! No! Now listen, there's a serious argument about when a player breaks a stick or loses a stick, if they should just go off the ice immediately because they're useless. And I can assure you, going to the point and attacking this guy without a stick would have been better! Not to mention it gets even worse because when he finally picks the thing up, the puck is basically in his feet and then it's just tapped in! So that's a solid, what, 5-6 seconds where you might as well not have had anyone on the ice instead of Nyes. You could have just been shorthanded instead. Then you could at least ice the puck. Brutal. Maybe he deserved to be benched. Now the Avs are within one. Here's goal number three, probably what got John Tavares benched. Here he is attacking the point at the speed of disc herniation. JT looks like DVP on this one because we're barely moving and I'm tearing my hair out. 3-3. Then with less than 4 minutes to go in the third period, the Avs catch the Leafs. The Avs get an odd man rush and Jake McCabe does his best to slow it down. This is what his best looks like. Oof, Maroon. He had a couple nice hits earlier in the period, but he took a really, really stupid interference penalty. Don't worry, we'll get to the rest. Really, really dumb penalty earlier in it. No one really had a good night here. MacKinnon rips that. You maybe like a save there from Martin Jones, but he had a good game otherwise, and it's Nathan MacKinnon! But enough about Jake McCabe. Here, let's have a look. Let's have a look. Who do we see? Who do we see? Simone Benoit has to take on two guys. Have fun with that. Jake McCabe is flat on his stomach against Nathan MacKinnon. It's, you know, it's not the first time Nathan MacKinnon has done that to another player. Where are the forwards? Where are the, oh, there's one. Mitch. Good job. Good job. Who else? Who else? Who? Oh, the other two forwards were Matthews and Nylander. The other two forwards were Matthews and Nylander. 13.25 and 11.5. Marner, only guy back there. Only guy back there. So in a game where Keefe was holding Bertuzzi and Tavares and Nyes accountable, it was the top line that he manufactured himself that was on the ice for the game-winning goal. Okay, okay. That's good, right? Is that good? Oh, it's not. It's not. It turns out it's not. And then we've already gone through the empty netter. This is, I never want to see this again. I never want to. Do you know how many Leafs would have to be scratched, would have had to have forgotten their things on the way to the arena before this is the trio I would want out there with the, what are you doing? Now, the refs. I do want to save like a little bit for the refs. They were genuinely terrible. Leafs took four penalties to the Avalanche's one. I'm not going to argue that any of the four that the Leafs took weren't penalties. Like, what McCabe did was dumb. That was dumb. The Geo hold, Kampf got his guy in the face right off the face-off, which is allowed if you play for the Minnesota Wild. What do you mean it's not allowed? What do you... Oh, it's a fine. It's a fine. But dude, the slash on Liljegren from Drouin going uncalled is brutal, and at that juncture in the game too. The camera goes to Liljegren on the bench after, and I'm pretty sure he says, I'm bleeding. That penalty goes uncalled, puck goes down the ice the other way, McCabe takes his boneheaded interference call on Rantanen, and yeah, that's a bad decision from McCabe. Should've never happened, the play should've been dead! And then, of course, the one that everyone's talking about, the cross-check on Austin Matthews that went uncalled. And after the game, Sheldon Keefe, who I just don't want to hear from right now, says the ref told him Matthews was not cross-checked, he fell on his own. I can't show you the footage, but I do have some stills that should illustrate what falling down on your own looks like. Here's Josh Manson coming in against Austin Matthews, elbows bent at 90 degrees, so he is fully loaded up.
There he is, driving the shaft of his stick right into where there's no padding.
But if you look at his elbows, there's still a little bit more in there, Josh.
And then here he is, after impact, fully extending. There you go, Austin. There you go. Here you go there. Fall down on your own now.
The referees for tonight's game, Kendrick Nicholson, who has done over 500 NHL games, and Kelly Sutherland, who has done just shy of 1,500 regular season games with another 230 in the playoffs. God save us all. Can I just offer you a little pet theory of mine? You know how the league is rigged in favor of the Leafs, that team that hasn't won since 2 years prior to the moon landing? Because the NHL has offices in Toronto and the video review room is in Toronto. You don't think these guys know that? I think a big issue in the league is too many of the officials are from Ontario. Like, just looking around the league tonight, how many games had a referee or a linesman from Ontario? Caps Rangers, they had an Ontario referee. Canucks Sabres, they had an Ontario linesman. Sharks Senators, they had an Ontario referee. And Wes McCauley, I think you're starting to see where I'm going with this. And they also had not one, but two Ontario linesmen. Devils versus Panthers, they had an Ontario linesman. Penguins Hurricanes, Ontario referee. Kraken Blue Jackets, Ontario referee. Kings Red Wings, Ontario linesman. Habs Oilers, two Ontario referees. Bet both teams love that. Ducks Lightning, Ontario referee and two Ontario linesmen. Avs Leafs, like I said, Ontario referee and two Ontario linesmen. Flyers Jets, Ontario referee and Ontario linesmen. Stars Blackhawks, Ontario linesmen. Coyotes Wild, Ontario linesmen. Bruins Blues, Ontario ref and Ontario linesmen. And there were two games on the entire Saturday schedule that did not have at least one Ontario ref or linesman.
Wow.
So the next time you have a lunkhead friend who tells you that the league is rigged in favor of the Leafs, add this to one of the many reasons that it's super not. I said this on the podcast and I'll say it again. When I was at Sportsnet, there were times where I was told, well, hey, well, that's maybe too much Leafs content. Because again, you don't want to have the appearance of a bias towards the Leafs. And I think what happens sometimes is the opposite. Dude, the slash on Liljegren's a slash. The Matthews cross check is a cross check. There were a few others that were borderline. I'm not going to whine about them. Max Domi didn't like the trip that was missed, for example, but trip in his opinion. And the other reason I don't want to put too much emphasis on those blown calls, because they were blown calls. It was a poorly officiated back half of the game. You can't be blowing a 3-0 lead on home ice. Have some pride! Here are some helpful tips for how to avoid this next time. Number one, don't get consistently outcoached when the other team has the opportunity to get run out of the building, go to intermission, plan their recovery, and it works every time. Hey, don't staple a dude you just recently healthy scratched to Nathan MacKinnon. And when you could still tie a one goal game with an extra attacker out there, don't throw out a line that is basically the human incarnation of Man Bear Pig. Questions. Can we have the Brody talk? Yeah, dude. I think Riley's had a good season. And Brody's his D partner, so Brody's got to have something to do with that. But I think Sheldon's about to get the blender out, and I think that pairing might get broken up. I don't know how. Honest to goodness, here's what I would do next game. I would have Riley out there with Liljegren. I think Liljegren deserves a bump up. I would keep McCabe and Benoit together. I would scratch Giordano for the next game. Not going forward, but I would scratch him for the next game. And I would let William Lagesson and TJ Brody argue over who gets to play the right side. Probably Brody, put Lagesson on the left. I just, my kingdom for a shutdown pair. Like a defense pair. What was the last D pair that the Leafs had that anyone was like afraid of? Like, oh no, they're gonna shut us down. Who? I'm not sure that's occurred in my lifetime. From Ashley, is this another example of the Leafs not being able to manage when a team they're dominating comes back from intermission and adjusts? It is. It's another perfect example. This team has one answer for that. Well, guess we'll just jumble the lines up.
But you don't actually see them change anything up, cut them off at the pass. It's zone entry, zone entry, zone entry, cycle, 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 shot, save, shot, rebound, shot.
Eventually it's gonna go in, and the Avs, who are good, did it. From the weird Bulldog, if these two make the finals, who wins?
Based on tonight's game, the Colorado Avalanche win by default because the Toronto Maple Leafs won't be there.
And last but not least, cross-checking. Legal?
Yep. It's the NHL. They don't care.
And if you complain about it, you're a whiny dork because rules are for nerds.
Well, that and like reputable sports leagues.
Man, I do not have any interest in talking about any positive from that game. I do not think there was one. The third line looked, whatever. Your third line's supposed to be good. What?
And also, I don't know if you noticed this, they still lost. The third line got a goal. It was the first one. And then what happened?
What? Like, their contributions were overshadowed by the fact that the team lost.
Listen, you are not going to win every game, okay? But you just blew a 3-1 lead and lost to the Islanders. But at least you did that in overtime. You blow a 3-0 lead on home ice this time to the Avalanche. This, considering that we're getting down to it, it's almost the All-Star break, right? We're approaching February. The second we get to February, we'll be 4 or 5 weeks away from the trade deadline. Considering that after the Christmas break is when teams start ramping up a little bit, this was as discouraging a loss as the Leafs have had all season. Unacceptable for where this team wants to be, and unacceptable for a team that has any aspirations of accomplishing anything. The team that you would play in the playoffs if they started today, right now, is the Florida Panthers, who kicked your ass last year and are 9-1 in their last 10. You are going to get annihilated if this is what you bring to the postseason. Luckily, it's not the postseason. It's January, but this is when the habits start. So Sheldon Keefe lit 2 points on fire in this game, lit them on fire to try to send a message to his team. Will that message resonate? Well, we'll find out tomorrow night when they start a friggin' mystery goalie because Sheldon Keefe is playing coy. How silly is it that we don't know? It should just be the backup goalie, who's Ilya Samsonov, but we don't even know if he's playable. So it might be someone starting their first ever NHL game. What a gong show of a defeat from the Leafs, and good riddance to them for the next 24 hours where they can't hurt our feelings anymore.
I mean, you guys are watching the game. Like, when McKinnon's line gets out there with Makar and Taves, I mean, the caliber of play, like, that's not, like, that's not the NHL. Like, that's another league.
That is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. If I told you Merry Christmas a few weeks ago, I take it back. Bah humbug, that game sucked.